jste zůstali až do konce.
Well, thank you that you stayed up to the very end. Well, so time for questions.
One of the things that I was wondering about, since I actually teach this as well as the book in one of my classes, is that you and Rob, when you guys did the screenplay, you decided to, instead of telling it in non-linear format as you do in the book, to tell it in linear format, which then places the ending climax with the investigation of the stamping at the same time as the bombing. I thought that was a brilliant move, but it wasn't part of the original book, and I was wondering if you could tell me a little bit about how you guys made that decision when you were doing the screenplay.
No, mně bylo jasný, že filmový divák není tak inteligentní jako čtenář.
I was sure that the film visitors are not that intelligent as the readers.
A chtěl jsem, aby tu knížku přijali i normální lidi, a proto jsem navrhl panu Hrabalovi, abychom dodrželi proti té knize, abychom dodrželi chronologii toho děje.
And I wanted that the people would accept the book, so I talked to Mr. Hrabal and I offered that we would keep the timeline as the story goes on, but that would be obvious.
Protože kniha, tam ty epizody jsou psané na přeskáčku.
In the book, the specific chapters are being shown in a different timeline.
A takže jsem vybral ty epizody a sestavil z nich takový outline a podle toho pan Hrabal napsal scénář.
So I choose the chapters, I put them in the line, and Mr. Hrabal wrote the scenario, the script.
A akorát nám to tak vyšlo, že vlastně ta banální scéna, to vyšetřování Zednička a vlastně ten hrdinský čin Miloše Hrmy šly paralelně vedle sebe.
And it just perfectly fitted, because the final investigation scene and the bravery of Miloš, the main character, clipped together.
Jsem rád, že jste tu knížku četl.
And I'm really pleased that you read the book.
A ten konec je v knížce psaný příliš drasticky.
And the end is described in a book in too drastic a way.
A myslel jsem si, že by to se vyjímalo z toho stylu toho filmu, kdyby to bylo takhle drasticky natočené.
And I thought that that would go out of the film visual style.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, you promised some gossip about Bohemian Rhapsody. You don't know about yourself.
Já žiju poctivým životem, ale mě žádný drp nemůže být.
I'm a decent citizen.
A na pana Hrabala vám řeknu akorát to, že pan Hrabal na rozdíl ode mě miloval pivo.
But I can tell you something about Mr. Hrabal. He, on the contrary from me, loved beer.
A tak jsme se těžko scházeli, já jsem nechtěl do hospody.
So it was difficult to meet him. I didn't want to go to the pub.
Protože mi to tam smrdilo pivem a někdy i kouřem a někdy i záchodem.
What a smelly place. It smells of beer, it smells of smoke and sometimes even toilet.
Takže když jsem s ním chvilku seděl a objednával si čaj v hospodě, tak pan Hrabal dělal, že ke mně nepatří.
When I was sitting with him in the pub and I was ordering the tea, Mr. Hrabal pretended he doesn't know me.
a říkal, že když jsem si objednával ten čaj, tak se číšník zatvářel, jako kdyby ten čaj musel sám vypít.
And he told me that when I was ordering the tea, the waiter's face was expressing the same disgust as if he would be pressed to drink the tea.
No, jinak pikantnosti nebyly žádný.
There are no PK moments.
Hello, sir. I apologize. Hello, here I am. You got it. Okay. First, let me apologize because I never read the book. And you've got five people up here.
Well, you can read it still.
Yeah, but you'll see why from the question. We have five people up here, and we're not sure who shot him. Who shot him?
Who shot Milos?
Who shot Milos?
Ten člověk, asistent, na chvilku mrknul, protože tam je záběr jak do toho vlaku, jak tam je ve vlaku, je v kabině, stojí voják a střílí. V kabině jednoho z těch vagonů.
There was a soldier in one of the wagons and he was the one who shot him.
To jste asi už spal v té době.
You were probably sleeping by that time.
I don't need it. Was that you as the doctor in this film? And if you could talk about acting in your own films.
No. K tomu došlo tak, že herec, který tu roli měl hrát, z nějakého důvodu se nedostavil ten den.
It happened that way. The actor, which was supposed to play, just didn't come.
Takže jsem naštěstí nebyl uvolený a tak jsem si vzal ten kostým a udělal jsem to za něj.
Fortunately, I didn't shave that day, so I just pick up the costume and I went.
I can speak loudly also. You know, someone like Henri Bazin, who had this huge impact on the French New Wave, is this great single figure who influenced numerous filmmakers. And the same is true of Harabal, who's of course a writer and a novelist. Why did he have such a big influence on so many of you in the New Wave?
Nestýkalo z dosavadní oficiální literaturu.
He brought something very new and fantastic, which really didn't go together with the official literature.
On zachycoval věci přímo ze života, právě ne tak realisticky, ale v té konfrontaci grotesky a tragedie.
He was bringing the stuff from the real life, and the most important was this contrary between grotesque and tragic moments of the life.
Pamatuju si, když jsem objevil jeho první povídku, která byla otištěná v jednom časopise, že jsem se smál a brečel zároveň.
I do remember reading his story, which was published in one of the magazines, and I laughed and cried at the same time.
To je ta Hrabalova specialita.
That's a speciality of Bohumil Hrabal.
Napětí mezi věcma nepříjemnýma a humorem.
It's kind of a special energy between a humorous and, well, unhappy, sad moments.
Z jakého důvodu byl váš film zakázán?
Why was your film censored and ended up in the trash?
Nebyl zakázán, normálně šel do kin, ale potom, když přišli Rusové, tak...
when the Russian army invaded Poland. blacklisted, and all of my films became blacklisted too. So that's why it was. And it wasn't just me, it was a lot of my colleagues too. Well, thank you very much indeed. We're going to. Those are the larks on the string.